that is Altan Khan, the founder of this city, HOHHOT, the capital of Inner Mongolia. Let's go. Okay guys, this is Darjal, the big lamasery in central HOHHOT. It's the oldest in the city as well, and it is vast and a very popular tourist spot, as you can probably see. Let's go and have a look around.
During the Ming and Qing dynasties, several hundred lamaseries existed in Inner Mongolia, and during the 16th century reign of Altan Khan, the founder of the city, there was widespread construction of Tibetan Buddhist complexes in the region. This lamasery was built in 1579 under Altan Khan and is the oldest and most visited in the city. Known commonly as Darjal, simply Big Monastery or the Big Lamasery, it has in the past seen visits of Dalai Lamas and emperors, a grand place indeed. The lamasery follows the basic design of a Chinese Ming Dynasty temple, but with some obvious differences. The halls are incredibly different inside. I wish I could show you, but no photos or videos in there. Also, prayer wheels and Tibetan Buddhist imagery adorn the buildings. This is a large lamasery, so take your time and wander.
So this was first built under Altan Khan's rule in 1557. It's actually the first building built here, and the rest of the city developed around it, which gives the city a pretty exact start date, which is not that old really when you consider, you know, further south in China proper, I suppose. If you're wondering why all of the roof tiles are golden, they never used to be. They were changed to golden because the Kangxi Emperor of the Qing Dynasty actually visited here. Qing also big patrons of Tibetan Buddhism, and that royal visit allowed them to change the tiles to give it imperial status.
I quite enjoyed this place, some quite rich history in the centre of the city, and an outside square full of life and madness. The original Mongolian name for HOHHOT translates as the Blue City, a reference to the big blue skies of the steppe, and yep, it still has them. Anyway, on to the next, which is very nearby.
China's biggest industry is girls dressing up in clothes and a new legion of camera guys who follow them around and take photos of them looking pretty in front of old architecture. Very interesting. So a lot of the historical sites in HOHHOT are all pretty close together, very central. Obviously the Darjal that we just went to, the big lamasery, the oldest one is, you know, just behind me. And the other really famous lamasery is just across the street. I can actually see it right now, so let's go and have a look. Let's go and have a look. I'm actually more looking forward to this one than the previous lamasery. And it looks very quiet, there's not many people here. So two yellow hat sect, Gelug sect Tibetan monasteries across the street from each other. So this white stupa is Qing Dynasty. It's quite lovely. This is the real treasure for me, of course.
Pagodas or stupas are comparatively thin on the ground in Inner Mongolia compared with other parts of China further south. However, this one is a beauty. It was built in the middle of the Qing Dynasty and is of course Tibetan in style. Dragons, lions and a whole host of mythical creatures decorate the stupa, and the walkway around it means you can get really close for a good look.
So behind me, this is the Sutra and Buddha Hall. It's marvellous inside. It was built in 1585, that's Ming Dynasty. And as you can see from the style, it's a real combination of both Han Chinese and Tibetan. Quite a special building, that. what a difference crossing the street makes. The big lamaserie was packed, as you can see from the video. This place is quiet. This is the Sili Tu monastery. It's not as big, there's not as much to see, and it's not as famous, I suppose, but it is still lovely. And I think if you're gonna visit HOHHOT, you know, come to both of them. Why not? They're right opposite each other. And you know, the Dajiao, the big monastery, it is lovely. I mean, it's just huge. It's got inside the halls, it's just, they're really quite marvelous, you know. Feels like you're in Tibet, really. So behind me is the Hall of the Ancient Buddha. It was the first building here in Sili Tu Monastery, and it's absolutely beautiful. Alright guys, onward. Having a good day. You know, I had a bit of a disappointment at the start of today, which you didn't see on camera, and that one of the things I wanted to see here is a diamond throne pagoda, and it looks absolutely amazing. And I've been here for a couple of days now, and I saved it to today, and when I went, it's closed on Tuesdays, and today is a Tuesday. Next time.
The majority of HOHHOT's population is Han Chinese, followed by Mongolian. However, there is also a significant Hui Muslim population living in the city, mostly in the Hui Muslim Quarter. Combining both Chinese and Islamic architecture, the Great Mosque of HOHHOT is the oldest in the city and dates back to the late 1600s with some more recent renovations. The minaret was a later addition. If you didn't see it, check out my video on the Grand Mosque of Tongxin in Ningxia. It will hopefully give you a good comparison of mosque architectural design in China.
So the mosque was built by the Hui Muslims. If you remember my videos from Ningxia, you know something about the Hui Muslims. And this area of the city is called the Hui Muslim Quarter.
Finally, all the way across the city for the true gem of HOHHOT.
So the airport here in HOHHOT is called the Baitar Jichang, the White Pagoda Airport, because outside of the city, not far from the airport, about 7 or 8 kilometers, is this. This pagoda is Liao Dynasty, and then was kind of reconstructed in the Qing Dynasty in 1162, which makes it actually a lot older than the city of HOHHOT. It's not actually in the city center at all, and it's not very visited, as you can see. There's two other guys over there looking around as well, and then just me. One of my friends who lives in HOHHOT is from HOHHOT. I saw yesterday for dinner, an old friend of mine I've known for a long time. She's never been here. She's never even seen it. It's really not very visited even by local people. It should be though, it's beautiful. The Liao dynasty and the following Jin dynasty were northern dynasties that controlled parts of parts of northern, what is today northern China. In the south of China, below the wall, it was the great Song dynasty. That was the Han ruled dynasty, and there was so many conflicts between these great powers until eventually the Mongols came in, swept them all away. I am blown away by this. This is one of the most beautiful pagodas I think I've ever seen. You used to be able to climb this, apparently, the dude on the door told me, but not anymore, unfortunately. As with a lot of kind of older pagodas in China, they're under pretty strict protection now, so no dice, I'm afraid. It's big as well, it's 56 meters high. It's a Yeah, I've been standing there for the best part of 900 years. It's a pagoda full of art. Outside, obviously, it's carved pretty exquisitely, but also inside it's full of, you know, scriptures and different languages from the different people who ruled these parts, whether it was the Liao dynasty, who were the Khitan people, or later the Jurchens, who were the Jin dynasty, and all of their scripts and languages are all written inside. shame, we can't go in. Never mind. Well, I think that is a true work of art. And I think a fitting place to finish this video from HOHHOT, the capital of Inner Mongolia. I hope you enjoyed it, guys. The next one will be from a much smaller, far away place. Until next time, all the best, take care and stay safe. Bye-bye.